and welcome back to Drummer Connection. Today we have a different type of drum lesson for you guys. It's called Finding the Groove. Before we get started, let's discuss what is a groove. And in my opinion, there's several different aspects that come into play and they're all equally important. Understanding subdivision is obviously very, very important. And if you have trouble doing that, please check out the lesson that I posted on that. I just sat there with the pad, we had the click going, and we're just looking at the different subdivisions against the quarter note, understanding how to fit those notes in between the quarter note. Very, very important. Once that's under your belt, I can't stress enough how much note placement comes into play. Very important. Also, you have to look at dynamics and your touch on the kit, how you play the drums, the sound you get out of the drums. So what we're going to do today to sort of simplify this, we're going to start this journey by looking at note placement. This is the first step, I would say, to really getting a great groove. There's much more to it, but this is definitely the first step. And even if you're just getting started, you can tune into this and start to develop your groove. So let's get going. Now, this is not a lesson on what to play or how to create a drum part. That's another lesson altogether. This is assuming that you know what you're going to play and you already have the kick, snare, the hi-hat, the whole pattern down, and you're ready to just to play musically and try and groove. And again, we're looking at note placement. Note placement is simply where you place your notes, where they fall against the quarter note. Typically, there's three types of note placement. There's dead spot on, and that's what we're going to go for today. That's also called burying the click, where when you're playing, the idea is to have each one of your hits, kick drum, snare drum, hi-hat, ride, whatever you're playing, and of course fills. We're not even getting into fills, we're just talking grooves. But everything you're playing within the grooves, every single voicing has to fit within this note placement and try and land dead spot on. This is much, much more difficult than it seems. And to be honest, it was probably one of the biggest hurdles that I had to ever overcome as a drummer. But when I did, my playing went from here to here. And it really separates the amateurs from the pros. That's dead spot on. Another type of note placement is to play slightly ahead of the beat and create this friction. And if it's done right, it's awesome and it's very cool to use. Another way that you can do that, I should say the third way, is to play behind the beat. Just a little bit behind, not actually slowing down, but just placing your notes a little behind. And again, done musically and in a controlled setting, it's awesome to do. So I'm not suggesting that you become machines and this perfect, you know, things that kick out these great rhythms. I'm saying to be able to control your notes. And if you choose to get a little ahead of the beat, it should be just that, a choice, a musical choice that you're controlling. And likewise, if you decide to lay it back, it should be your decision to play it that way. It shouldn't be just your limbs just sort of getting carried away from you and just flying off and playing whatever. That's what we're trying to control. So I'm going to give you a couple of examples. Like I said, you could start out as a beginner doing this. I'm going to play a basic beat. Eighth notes, 1 and 3 on the bass drum, 2 and 4 on the snare drum. It's at 100 beats per minute. What I'm going to attempt to do is to play ahead of the beat. You're going to hear this friction happening between my playing and the click. And what I'm trying to do is push notes, sometimes a bass drum, sometimes a snare. But check this out, see if you can hear the friction. So I'm sure you could hear something a little off there. It's not always easy to detect these notes, especially in the beginning if you're just getting started into this concept. As with anything, the more you do it, the better you get. The better your ear gets, the better you can control what's happening. But I'm pretty happy to say that that's tough for me to do what you just heard. I've been spending so many years trying to control and be dead spot on because, in all honesty, 99% of the gigs that I've done require dead spot on, especially with sequencers and click tracks and things that are going on these days with technology. There's not a lot of room for drifting, but sometimes there is, but the majority of the time I'm dealing with dead spot on. Now let's take a look at the other extreme, playing behind the beat. Gonna do the same thing, play a simple groove, just like you heard. The click track's still at 100 beats per minute. This time, the friction's gonna come from me laying behind the groove. See if you can hear this. Thank you. So those two examples demonstrate a lot of what I call rhythmic friction. And I can only give the analogy of swimming upstream. It's that uncomfortable. And it drives me crazy. Now I'm going to give you a demonstration of trying to bury the click. And I'm sure you're going to hear a difference now. Same tempo, same groove. I'm going to try and lock dead spot on with the click and create the best groove I can. See if you can hear this. Okay, that was a demonstration of the three different types of note placement. Simple groove just with a click. Now let's make it a little more musical. So what I did, I grabbed a play along off of drummerconnection.com. I got the Coldplay style ballad. I just chose that one because the music's really nice. It's got the click going. And we're going to do the same thing. Going to take a section. I believe it comes in about a minute and 26 seconds into the song. I'm going to use that same exact section and give you guys the same exact demonstration. I'm going to try and play this take edgy, ahead of the groove, and swimming upstream. Okay, so you can hear hopefully what I'm talking about. I always tell people, if you're listening to a song that grooves really well, chances are you're going to bob your head or tap your foot and feel the music. I seriously doubt any of you guys were doing that for that take. I'm going to give you a demonstration now of playing behind the beat. Same section of the song. This time I'm just going to randomly lay the hits between the kick and snare back a little bit. And finally, it's time to turn around and swim downstream. Now I'm going to attempt to do a take where I'm going to lock with the click, really lock with the track and try and be dead spot on, and I'm sure you're going to hear a big difference. A few quick notes as we wind down this lesson. Remember, you're never too early in the game to start this, to think about this and become aware of this. It's not easy to accomplish, but just like I gave you the demonstration with the basic groove at the beginning, you can do that with your playing. Technology is awesome. It's easy to record yourself these days. So start to do that and listen back. It's really going to separate, like I said, the amateurs from the pros. And another thing is, today we just looked at groove, just keeping time. This whole concept applies to everything you play on the kit, unless you're doing some sort of open solo, which has no reference to time. Otherwise, all your fills, everything that you do, fall under the same umbrella of having to really lock it in. So, obviously, the busier you get, the more difficult it becomes. So, that's why we start with a nice, basic groove. You guys have fun with this stuff. Be patient, don't beat yourself up, and you're on your way to becoming a professional. We'll see you next time.